Tony Girard, Shawnee College, Science in Seconds here. I want to talk about the tree that makes these things, and maybe you've seen these before. Now, this is leftover from last year, but this is a honey locust pod. And it's called that. This one's too old to have it, but if you rip it open when it's new, it's got a kind of greenish-yellow little goopy textured stuff in there, but it's very, very distinctly sweet. And this also has the seeds in it, this pod. Now the tree itself is this one, and you notice there's got big clusters of thorns, but they're fairly scattered out. So there's big clusters of thorns, they're not enough to keep an animal from climbing the tree or something. What's the point of having thorns like that? Now this tree is native to North America. Those thorns are protection against elephants. Okay, you've seen an elephant on Wild Kingdom or something, the way they wrap their trunk around a branch and just rip all the bark and leaves and everything off. You're not gonna do it if it's got big clusters of thorns like that, right? But this is native to North America. Why would you need to be adapted to elephant predation in North America? Because it hadn't been, but about 14,000 years ago we had elephants, right? We had mammoth and mastodon and things like that. And that was probably their original seed disperser. This sweet stuff in the seed pod. Okay, elephants probably like to eat that, right? So you would very carefully as an elephant pick the pods and eat them and then poop these seeds out someplace away from the parent tree so it's not competing with its own offspring, and you didn't rip off big chunks of bark and things like that in your grazing process. It's what they call an anachronistic fruit. It's adapted to a seed disperser that's no longer present. How cool is that?